Another?
A rum flip this time.
And where'd I find fresh eggs in this wretched town? There's little else but piss and insects.
Aye, we're working on that.
Dear lady, what do they call you?
And when they're sober, a jilt when they're sauced. But never, lady.
Well, good Leanne,
bag of shite! Do you hear me? It's a bag of bloody shite!
It's a ruse to keep us off before they attack Nassau. You'll see, mark me.
It's no ruse, Fiend. I heard it straight from the mouth of a greasy Bermudan captain. There's a pardon on offer for any pirate that wants it.
Ruse or no, I think it's plain the British may return to Nassau with arms, no doubt. We'll need a plan.
Walk with us, Kenway. There's trouble brewing.
In the absence of any clear ideas, I say we lay low. No piracies and no violence. Do nothing to ruffle the king's feathers for now.
Preserving the king's plumage is no concern of mine, Ben.
It will be when he sends his soldiers to scrub this island clean of our residue. Look around you, man. Is this cesspool worth dying for?
Aye! It's our republic! Our idea! A free land for free men, remember? So maybe it's filthy to look at. But ain't it still an idea worth fighting for?
I can't be sure. But when I look on the fruits of our years of labor, all I see is sickness, idleness, idiocy.
Not a sunbeam of difference between here and London, then, eh?
Thatch is right, man. Taking a wide view, we're not doing so bad out here. The sun, rum, and leisure as far as the eye can see.
Aye. Nassau may look fine from a distance, but at its core, there's a disease I cannot stomach.
Sickness can be cured, Ben. If only you have the right medicine.
But a corpse cannot be reanimated.
I can't believe the shite I'm hearing drop from your lips. Why not take the pardon now and be done with it?
Peace, both of you. We can satisfy both aims if we work together. Find medicines to ease our burdens here, but in a way that don't attract the British.
I wager the nearest doctor is sitting pretty in Havana. Not a place I mean to go.
But the Spanish fleet that sunk 2 years back would have some medicine. All sealed up in glass vials.
You'd need a diving bell to reach those depths.
Aye, and with some coin and a few supplies, a diving bell won't be hard to come by.
This is a plan I can stand behind. Find medicines without stirring up trouble. Agreed, Thatch?
Agreed. Aye. I'll meet you near the wrecks as soon as you're able, Kenway.
Remember, Thatch, keep your cannons corked.
Piss off, Ben.
Something I can assist with? Most satisfactory.
places marked, and set up your coat in order to in the bully good rough and tumble. Oh! Early in the morning, sail the places marked. I think so go, I think so go. Sail the lights, I think so go.
Devil in his hole, Thatch. This is a darling galley. 32 guns, is it?
I lost count at 40.
You've stepped up a rung. So, any luck finding medicines here?
Nothing round this spot, sadly. But there's a few wrecks yonder that ain't been scoured by nothing but crabs and coral.
I'll have a look.
Edward? Edward, is that you? My goodness, the West Indies is a compact place.
Hello, Bonnet. A surprise seeing you out here.
I met Mr. Thatcher a month or so ago, and he offered to take me under his yardarms, so to speak. Says I must wash the hayseed from my hair before I'm a true pirate.
Well, good luck to you then. Worse men have become better under Blackbeard's watch.
Thank you.
Ahoy! Any luck?
I found one crate hidden beneath a school of sharks. Sadly, the elixir inside is quite spoiled.
Plague and perish. Will we steal medicines now?
Remember the pardon, Thatch. We're to be subtle.
Says Ornigold, a pirate, now too proud to call himself one.
He prefers caution to cannons.
Caution's nothing without charisma. If a man plays the fool, then it's only fools he'll persuade, but appear to be the devil. And all men will submit.
And would you be the devil?
For an audience. Aye. It's all a big show. Give your quarry something to fear. Some hellish thing from a fever dream. And men will drop to their knees, pleading for their lord before all else.
Oh, God.
Looks fine.
Of course it does. You can find a quiet way to acquire medicines. Tell me soon. Otherwise, I'll handle it myself.
What the hell's happened here? Were you attacked?
Other way round. It were Blackbeard who struck first. Opened fire on a British man of war, the pillock.
What in God's name for?
Still searching for medicines. But he's gone barmy if you ask me.
I'll bring him home.
Leave him, man. He's heaped this trouble on himself.
Captain, there's a wreck yonder. Looks recent.
I see it. Let's hope Thatch hasn't come to the same end.
Another bit of wreckage, Captain. This is looking grim.
Aye. Keep your eyes peeled. Blast. This is getting well out of hand.
A dozen crates of medicine should not be so hard to cover.
That ain't my meaning. Thatch and Hornigold, it's a pointless feud of theirs. Can't you feel it?
I do, aye. But both men have their hearts in a good place. Both want the best for the people of Nassau.
But is that the best course for us? Saving a city that ain't worth much. We're not men made to govern. We take and spend and live heartily wherever we go.
What solution would you propose?
The answer's in wealth and power, not politics. If we found the observatory, we'd see enough money to buy the whole. Or it might be we'd lord over these kings and emperors like they was peasants themselves.
A lot of large talk, Captain. But is it your crew you sail for, or yourself?
I mean the best for these men, Ade. I do. But this don't sit right. I feel like I'm running errands, not living my life.
Cannot be far now.
Come in! Pass the wine! Shift it around!
she's in a bad way.
No time for a vote. Thatch is outnumbered.
The crew will understand. Beat the quarters, lads! We're sailing into hell!
Thatch is overwhelmed. I'm going ashore.
I'll keep the Jackdaw circling.
I hope you mean.
Aye! A galleon nearby! And if we crack these lobsters quick, we might catch up to her! It's all your book learning! Prepare you for a scuffle of this sort, Mr. Bonnet!
Not in the least, no.
For certain, there's more to be learned by doing than reading. Remember that!
Heads up!
Back to my ship, quick as you please. She'll not slip away now.
Oh, this is too much!
I'll see you back to the Jackdaw when the smoke is clear. But for now, I need a helmsman.
Call it out.
Loose the mains! And head straight for that bloody ship! We'll have our medicines in little time at all!
I'm not a man accustomed to murder, Captain. And if you're taking quarter, you'd not be sleeping now.
Sack of muzzle, gumshite! You'll be hanged and sun-dried, just as them there were in Boston.
The king's called for a pardon.
Captain, we've searched the hold. It's a middle intake, but the medicine we found bears a Charlestown stamp.
Thank you, Mr. Hans.
We cannot resupply Nassau out here by force and accident alone. We should go to Charlestown for the lot.
Hello! Are we victorious? I fear I am not built for the fatigue and care required to live as a man of fortune.
Meet me in Charlestown. 1 month from today.
Bonnet? Flying your own flag at last?
Yes. Yes, Blackbeard cut me loose, sadly. Time to have a go at this myself.
Well, that's grand.
Yes, it's for the best, I think. I should have some wild stories when next we meet. Edward! Your constant friendship has been my most treasured find on these seas. Well above gold and silver and rum, I prize the courage you have inspired in me this year. Thank you, sir! A fair good morrow to you!
Are you not lost, Dom? Are you not wanted by your wives, families, and countrymen? How else to explain your government's complete disinterest in your well-being? Hostages for merchants! These were my only terms! And yet, 6 days of pure fucking sight. So I must conclude that you men are the pariahs of Charlestown, and I would profit better by using your organs for chum and your bones for char. By Christ! This is my predicament. To kill you, or to press you into my service. It's a decision I'll make hardly, but not with remorse. Ahoy, Edward.
What the hell are you doing, man? All of Charleston can see this mess.
It's the idea. Out of range, but well in sight.
So where's the medicine?
We sent a party ashore to partner with the governor. That were a week ago. No noise, since.
I'll handle it. Give me a day.
There's movement up ahead. Is it soldiers?
Aye, and in something of a hurry. I propose we follow, else they spring something we ain't ready for.
What's your thinking?
Blackbeard's been at this 8 days already. So it's a good bet someone out there has prepared the medicines, just in case.
Ah, but they're stalling, thinking up ways to avoid paying it out.
Aye, so let's find where they've gathered and hope for the best.
Careful, Captain. We're drifting close to a watchtower.
Jackdaw's got more business here in some shallow waters.
There's another watchtower. Keep her at half sail, Captain. Speed will do us no favors here. Careful with the banks. We cannot pass them undetected, Captain. And there is no other way.
There's always another way.
All stop!
See them. Over there.
More sail.
Let us hope the river remains this wide.
This ship's built for the open ocean, not stalking bites.
If we run aground here, we may never get out. Be sure they don't spy us trailing them.
Steady as she goes, Captain. They're getting away, Captain.
Then I'll have to go on without her. I'll be back with the medicines.
Aye, sir.
Another time, mate. Bit of a hurry.
Syphilis and scurvy, no doubt. What noxious choppings these pirate ships must be.
What was that? It was a crocodile, wasn't it? It's coming straight for us, I can feel it. Seen any crocodiles tonight? They've passed the boat.
Nope. Quiet night.
Are you sure? There's something in the water.
Quiet till you showed up. Go on then. Captain's waiting.
There was an accident. Private Simon. This crocodile.
I don't care about your accidents. What's the word from the harbor, soldier? Speak.
No change, sir. They're holding fast, but are yet to kill or maim any of the captives, near as we can tell. Perhaps it's time to...
To surrender? I've been entrusted with the affairs of the town, and I do not intend to bow to the demands of a pirate, no matter how fierce his reputation.
Yes, sir.
As long as the supply key is with me, no man shall touch that medicine. May plague and calamity strike them all.
Bloody idiot.
What?
Pirates! The ship's here! Pirates! Fall back to the mansion!
The gunner will have your head.
Where do you think you're going?
Blackbeard made you as good an offer as ever a man got from any pirate. You might curse his methods, but medicine was all he wanted. And now he'll get it. You should have bartered, mate.
He has returned, Captain!
What's the take?
Two crates. And the means for mixing additional doses.
That's right, thinking precious little of that these days.
You hear that, Mr. Rags? My young friend returns with offerings and so saves your scrawny neck. Will you not thank him?
We should quit these waters, Thatch. The governor,
He's bound to muster more soldiers.
You go on ahead. I got some business in the north.
You're done, aren't you? Giving up on us. On Nassau.
Look, lad. I'm late into my fourth decade on this earth. And if I don't find some means to make the fifth quiet and cozy voyage, I'd rather sink to the devil's doorstep than call myself captain another year. We'll meet again, lad. In this world.
Or the one below.